Hello students, how are you? Attention here, 12 students, subject business maths and statistics. Yesterday we completed rank of a matrix using determinant method now. Then we got a assignment for that topic. 2 by 2 for matrix for 4 sums, 3 by 3 matrix for 3 sums. For that answers, we can see first one is, answer is rank of A is equal to 2. Second one answer is rank of A is equal to 2. Third one answer is rank of A is equal to 1. Fourth one answer is rank of A is equal to 2. 3 by 3 matrix. First one answer is rank of A 3. Second one answer is rank of A is equal to 3. Third one answer is rank of A is equal to 2. I hope you completed this yesterday assignment. Today we are going to learn about elementary transformations of a matrix. This method is very simple. Interchange of any rows or columns. Ri is equivalent to Rj. Ci is equivalent to Cj. Second one is multiplication of each element of a row by any non-zero scalar k. Ri is equivalent to Kri. Addition to the elements of any row or column, the same scalar multiples of corresponding elements of any other row or column. So, using this elementary transformations procedure, make echelon form and finding the rank of the matrix. What is that echelon form? Every row of A which has all its entries 0 occurs below every row which has a non-zero entry. Let us find the rank of the matrix using elementary transformations. Okay. Find the rank of the matrix A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, 5, 7. This one is 3 by 3 matrix. Order of A is 3 by 3. Therefore, rank of A will be less than or is equal to 3. Now, we are moving. Let us transform to the matrix A to an echelon form by using elementary transformations. So, matrix A we are taking now. This one, R1, R2, R3. Row 1, row 2, row 3. Now, we are doing this rows transformations. You will get some idea. I am doing R2 minus 2R1. Then one more possible is R3. You can try any other transformations. Okay. Any other way we can do it. R3 minus 3R1. I am doing this. I am taking these two procedure. So, R2 is equivalent to R2 minus 2R1. So, we are taking 1, 2, 3. R1 no other changes. R1 no change. R2 that is 2, 3, 4 this row. We are taking first 2 minus 2R1. R1 is first element 1. So, that is 2 minus 2 that is equal to 0 we are getting. Next element is 3. 3 minus 2 into element R1 la, that is 2. So 3 minus 4 that is minus 1. Next element is 4 from R2 minus 2 into from R1 that element is 3. So 4 minus 6 that is minus 2 we are getting now. So R2 process is completed. Next come to the R3 procedure. R3 that is 3 minus 3 R1, first 1, first element. 3 minus 3, that is we are getting 0. Understood? So next element is 5 from R3 minus 3 from R1. Next is 2. So 5 minus 6, that is minus 1. Next one is from R3, 7 minus 3 into R3 minus 3R1. 3 into R1 is 3. So, 7 minus 9 that is equal to minus 2. So, we got this matrix. Now one more procedure we can do it. Why? That is, we need to find echelon form. What is that echelon form I said? Isn't it? What is that echelon form I said? We remember every row of A which has all its entries, zero occurs below row which has a non-zero entry, no? So now we need this echelon form. This also will be zero. So this element will be zero means how we will get zero from this R1 and R2? We will get an idea. Minus 1, minus half, minus 1, plus 1 will be 0 now. So this one is R3, this one is R2. Next step is R3 minus R2. R1, R2, no changes. 0, minus 1, minus 2. R3 only we are doing. R3 minus R2. R3 0 minus R2, that also 0, that is equal to 0. Then next element from that R3 minus 1 minus R2, that is minus 1. So minus 1 minus to minus plus 1, that is equal to 0. Then R3 from R3 minus 2 minus of R2 minus 2. So minus 2 plus 2 is equal to 0. So we got echelon form. Okay, after getting echelon form, how many number of non-zero rows are there? We can calculate. Number of non-zero rows means, you know, non-zero. That is not zero. So this one row, one, and then this also. At least one element also is there means you can calculate. So that rank of A is equal to 2. Why means this fully zero, this row fully zero, zero row. This one, number of non-zero elements are 2. Therefore, rank of A is equal to 2. Understood? Okay, students, now you understood. Find the rank of the matrix for that elementary transformations method, no? Shall we do one more example sum? Find the rank of the matrix. This is also using elementary transformations. Okay. Let they given A is equal to 0, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, 1, 3. This one 3 by 4. Order of A is 3 by 4. Here also possible rank of A less than or is equal to 3. We are taking that matrix A. Elementary transformations. You can't get any other idea. So, first one is, for this elementary transformations, we can note it down. One more point is, first element should be 1 means that process will be easy. So, first element will be 1 means that R2 have 1. So, I am doing that R1 is equivalent to R2. So, interchanging the rows. So, now 1, 2, 3, 2, R2. Then R1, 0, 1, 2, 1. Then R3 same. 3, 1, 1, 3. Now we can do the elementary transformations. Any other idea? Do you have elementary transformations? I said no. You can use any other procedure. But I am taking here R3 is equivalent to R3 minus 3R1. One more possible R3 is equivalent to R3 plus 5R2. We need to get echelon form. Then we can count number of non-zero rows. That's why we are doing elementary transformations now. So you can use any of your own method. So R3 only we are changing now. First R3 we are changing now. So 1, 2, 3, 2, 0, 1, 2, 1. I am doing that R3 minus 3R1 procedure. First R3 element 3 from R1 minus 3, 1, 3 into 1, 3 minus 3 is 0. Next one more is R3 1 minus 3 R1, that 1 minus 6, that is minus 5. Then one more, next element 1 minus R3 minus 3 R1, that is 1 minus 9, that is equal to minus 8. Then next element R3 3 minus 3 R1 is 2, 3 minus 6, that is minus 3. So one more procedure also I said now. This one I completed. R3 is equal to R3 plus 5R2. Y means here minus 5 had now. So plus 5 into R2. Plus 5 into 1 means we will get 0 now. We will get eclan form now. We can count the number of non-zero rows. Let us come to that. R1 is no other changes. 1, 2, 3, 2 R1 is. Then R2 is 0, 1, 2, 1. R3 is what I said. R3 is R3 tends to R3 plus 5 R2. So R3 element is 0 plus 5 R2. R2 is 0, that is 0. Next element from R3 minus 5 plus 5 into R2 is 1. So that is minus 5 plus 5, 0. Next element from R3 minus 8 plus 5 into R2 is 2 from R2. Minus 8 plus 10, that is 2. Next element from R3 minus 3 plus 5 into from R2 1. So minus 3 plus 5, that is equal to plus 2. So now we got eclan form now. Eclan form. So how many number of non-zero rows are there? Number of non-zero rows is 3. Number of non-zero rows is equal to 3. Therefore, rank of A is equal to 3. Understood? Now, we can do, you can try any other sums. I will give 3 sums for yourself. Find the rank of the matrix. First one is A is equal to 1, 1, 1, 1, 3, 4, 5, 2, 2, 3, 4, 0. Like this, 4 sums I gave for you. You can do this example sums. We are completing the exercise. First 4 sum, first 2 Roman letters also. So, these 2 days we completed. Find the rank of the matrix. Determinant method and elementary transformations method also. You can complete these 4 sums also. Then you will get, find the rank of, you will get rank of the matrix. Thank you. Next class, we are going to learn about elementary transformations again. Then find solving the value of XYZ variables also. Okay. Next, tomorrow we will start the procedure. Thank you.